All right, nerds, I am going to teach you how to use my Unfortunately Challenge spreadsheet. Who am I? I'm Adrienne Dawes, aka Heckle Her. I am a playwright and producer, originally from Austin, Texas, but right now living in Memphis, Tennessee for residency. You can go to my website, adriennedawes.com, to learn anything about me that you need to know. But this video, I'm going to really try in 10 minutes to explain my spreadsheet for the Unfortunately Challenge, because if it takes more than 10 minutes, it's probably not going to be something that's useful to anyone. If you already have some Excel or spreadsheet skills, then there'll be some things that you can do to add on to this. If you know nothing about Excel, I'm going to hopefully give you just enough to make use of this spreadsheet. Boop. You can access this file by going to my website, adriennedawes.com/unfortunately. There's a whole story that you can read or not read about why I did this challenge. If you click on the image, it'll take you to this spreadsheet. The first thing you need to do when you open this is to save a copy of this file to your G Drive so that you have access. This is a public file as is, so any changes that happen, everyone can see. This is not the place to put your own personal submission information. Go to File, make a copy. It'll look like that. I put it somewhere that's easy to find. Usually this will default at the bottom here to just my drive, but if not, make sure you get to that, but select, and then give it whatever unique name you want, and you'll say okay, and then it'll open up the new document. Okay, so once you've saved a copy, first tab is called Start Here, and you can see the lock because there are things locked down about it. The thing that is not locked are these yellow cells. You can input anything you want into these. First challenge is to determine when you want to start your year-long challenge, and I went ahead and put today's date in, and then what is your goal? This is up to you to decide. Are you doing 100 rejections in a year, 100 submissions in a year, or are you going for the super crazy 100 acceptances in a year? So I'm going to go ahead and do 100 rejections. And you'll see with this little arrow down, this is a drop-down menu. So it's just giving you those three options. That's it. And then this other question, what is your estimated acceptance rate? So just guess, out of all the submissions you put out into the world, what is the percentage that will come back a yes? If you hover over this cell, you'll see that there's a note that says Real Talk. My annual percentage rate is somewhere between 4 and 5%. Some writers that I know pull 7 to 8%. I'd say something like 10% is very, very confident. I'm going to go ahead and leave this at 5, but if I wanted to change it to 6, I want you to pay attention to the cells down here. When I do that, there's calculations happening to let you know, okay, if I'm going to have a 6% acceptance rate and my goal is 100 rejections, how many submissions do I need in the year? How many rejections, acceptances? And then down here are like the per day calculation. Behind the scenes, the spreadsheet is using that calculation to let you know, are you on track or off track from what you should be doing? After you do the Start Here, you can hide it if you want. It doesn't delete it, it just takes it out, because your day to day is actually going to be in the submissions tab that has the teal or like bright turquoise color. We're gonna start on Unforch, short for Unfortunately, just to give you an idea of what it looks like. And then I'll show you, we'll kind of go back and forth between these two tabs, Unforch and Submissions. All Unforch is kind of a summary place. It's pulling from the goals that you just set and Start Here, and then with the submission stuff, automating a summary. And this is new. This was not the original spreadsheet that I shared, did not have this. And as I was looking at it, I was like, man, this is really impractical for people. You don't want to have to be doing data entry into two places. Let me see if there's a way I can automate this. So you're welcome. By the way, plug, if you would like to give me any sort of donation for this labor, my Venmo is Heckle Her. You'll see that there's a lock on this tab now. You cannot do any editing here. All this is reiterating the start and end date of your goal. How many days since you started the goal? Your days left, what was your goal? And then right here is like this, how many should I have? Sometimes it is helpful once a week, once a month to come and take a look at this. Like, are you on track? If you are, you're going to see some green. So you're doing it means that you are on track for submissions, your unfortunately rejections, or your acceptances. Down here is a month by month, play by play. How many submissions did you do in the month? How many rejections? How many acceptances? This will turn to green automatically when you have 30% or more. Just, I think that's worth celebrating if you have really been churning out the submissions. For a rejection challenge, we actually are looking for rejections. So those are also going to be in green. And then of course, acceptances. Wow, if you get some in the first couple months, you're doing awesome. Go ahead and go into submissions, because this is really where you do the work. Starting at the very left of the submissions, there's a column for fees. So if you paid an entry fee, any amount, you'd put that there. Some people feel very strongly about never applying to things with fees that may or may not be you. Let's pretend that for the submission, I paid $5. And you'll see at the top here, this is already calculating a sum. I will say that this sheet is open to editing, so you can move things around. Just know that that might affect some of the other formulas. I'd say if you were adding columns, that won't really do too much. But if you delete specifically the submission date, status, and status date columns, that's going to mess up some other formulas. So I don't recommend doing that unless you know Excel very well. Let's pretend we did a submission today. We did it to theater company. We're going to pretend this is in my hometown of Austin, Texas. I'll just say here about the location. I, in my personal sheet, keep tabs on like where my work geographically is doing better or worse, just because that might help me prioritize other submissions. I'm also in a place in my life where I'm thinking about maybe possibly moving to a new place. And so I'm kind of, that's why I have that data. Maybe in another video, I can show you what my actual sheet looks like. Okay, under play, this is your play title. I have some conditional formatting on this column so that when I enter in a specific play title, a specific color comes up. If this is something you want to do for your own work, you can Google that, conditional formatting. You could do something with data validation where there's a drop-down menu, and I do use that. You'll see when there's drop-down. If you know Excel, you know what I'm talking about. But if you don't know Excel and you want additional help, you can always reach out to me. I'm happy to, for hire, help people build their own sheets. But anyway, play title goes there. Submission. I use this field a little differently than I do the notes. This might tell me, okay, I sent a 10-page excerpt. It was the June 2018 draft, something like that. And then submit type was an email, website, mail. That's helpful, especially when you're trying to figure out, when you're trying to like backtrack and do follow-up, like it can get really confusing, especially if you have hundreds of submissions that you do in a year. Let's pretend I did an email for this one. Status and status date. You're gonna leave these blank until you have heard back from this opportunity. So if I hear back from them and it's a rejection, I'll do unfortunately. Boom, it automatically changes color. That's conditional formatting. If I get an acceptance email, boom, accepted, and I'll put the date. Let's pretend this would be like so nice, wouldn't it? If like in 4 months you knew you got something. The status date is connected to what the status is. I only use pending if I make it to round two of something. And I actually leave the status date blank on that. I might write in my notes, made round two, final notice in December or something like that. That's where you can do notes. Notes is free form. You can put whatever you want there. It can be, you know, what was your lead source? How'd you find out about the op? If you've met someone from that company, you can really do whatever you want. I also, even sometimes when I submit and I don't ever want to submit there again, I have my reasons, I might put a big X because then I can easily filter or do searches based off of stuff like that. So notes can be really helpful in that way. But let's pretend we have unfortunately, or let's say we just need to take it out. You can just delete. Blank is also an option to you, and you'll put the date there. And then honorarium, so if this was an acceptance and they gave you money, lucky you, you're being paid for your art. You'll notice at the top here, K is adding up how much did you spend. This is really great data to know on an annual basis. How much are you making from your art? And then with the fees, how much are you spending? This is not, of course, calculating things like how much you spend on postage and supplies, but it's just some data. So now we have a lot of data. Okay, we made a lot of submissions. And you can continue to add to this. You'll see that this goes on forever and ever. You'll notice there's this green line here. There's filters put on the third row. And the green line is the edge of what it's filtering. Just a pro tip, if you needed to turn the filter off for some reason because you have more cells that keep going beyond that green line, go to data, turn off filter. You're gonna notice that green line disappears. As you continue to add things, let's pretend I'm just gonna copy and paste. Now if I go back to the third row and I go to data, create filter, it's gonna pop that on again. This is so helpful if you're like trying to sort by date or company name or the submission type, all of these columns, any of these can be sorted. All right, let's go back to Unforge. We have all this data, look at this, it automatically populates. According to the data we just entered, we have 10 submissions, 6 of them have been unfortunately, 4 have been accepted. And it gives us an idea like, how are we doing? Looks like we're pretty on target for all of these goals. Let's go back to start here. If I were to say 100 acceptances, whoo buddy, I would have to make 5 submissions a day. Then you'll notice here at Unforge, switch back my goal changed and like saying, come on, this is like in the Job voice from Arrested Development. So you can kind of see what that looks like. And that's the update, is that you don't have to then enter in data here. It's already talking to that submission. So I forgot to film an outro. So here we are hours later. If this Unfortunately Challenge is helpful to you, please hashtag Unfortunately Challenge so I can see what your spreadsheets look like. I said spreadsheets. If this submission tool is helpful to you, please use it. Please share it. If it is not, please don't use it. Again, I'm on social media as HeckleHer. You can visit my website if you want to know more about my artistic work. And again, if you would like to Venmo your appreciation, I am also at HeckleHer. I would definitely appreciate that. Leave me a comment, email if you have questions. There's other things you want to see or know about. I am happy to help. Namaste. Stupid.